Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the World of Wayne. We now got box 5 of the Agora Models release of Builder 2A6 Leopard Tank. This is a big old box, this one is. We've got quite a bit of armour to put on. We've also got hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of the tracks to put on. Now, you'll be pleased to know, I've already done all of those. So, this is what they're looking like now, and they're getting longer. Look, it does look like what Chewbacca would wear. We got two of these, one's slightly longer than the other. One's got three more little track parts than the other one, but I'm not going to go through and just show you me doing every single one. I think we get 9 lots of them in this one, so you'll have some fun doing those. What I've done is I just took them all out of the packs and did them all together. So I've got that one there, and we've got this ginormous one here as well. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, I'll put the link down here to the Agora Models website. You can get this all the way from pack one. And over at Agora Models website at the moment, you have got the Shelby Snooker Snake, the Cobra, the Bismarck, the Routemaster Bus, the Leopard Tank, the Zero Fighter, the New York Fire Truck. I'm too shy today. I'm always forgetting. But there you go. You check that out on the Agora Models website. But I think without further ado, let's get cracking. So we're gonna start with stage 34. We've got these parts here. Getting this out. Now this U-shaped section here is actually metal, just so you know. Quite rigid as well. And we have got some small details here as well. Now this massive section here that we actually put the metal plate in last time is what we're actually going to start working on at the moment. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to be taking this detail, comes in this pack, looks like that. That's just going to go into this triangle section just here. Line it up and push that all the way home there. Now I'm going to put that just to one side because we are going to be working on this metal section just here. And we have got 2 tabs to put at the bottom. This is what the tabs look like. They have got a little lug coming out of one side there. So what we want to do is just put these on this way. Make sure that the tabs are pointing in the same direction for both sides. So I put this one on here as well. So as you can see, they're on both sides there. And then once again, bringing over the section that we've just been working on, we're going to push these tabs into the holes that we've got here. But this metal bar is going to go underneath the lips of these sections here. So it is going to take some pushing. You know what? That was quite tricky. But as you see, I've got both of those in. And that's looking just like that. Now you will have to make the next 3 sections a track. But as you know, I've already done that. But that's all there is to do in that stage. So in stage 35, we've got this section here, and you will have some more track, but once again, you're going to get sick and tired of me saying it. I've already done the track. Now, because I've already done the track, we don't actually do anything. We're actually going to save this till next time. So I think that just goes for me to show you once again what the track's looking like. When you're doing the track, it is important to make sure all of these side pieces are exactly round the right way. And on my one, all the dots on the top, they're all the same way as well. So make sure everything is uniform, but that's what the track is looking like. Let's move on to stage 36. So in stage 36, we've got some grills just for the section that we've just had from the last stage. Once again, we're gonna be bringing over this section that we've been working on last time, turning it upside down. And then in these sections here is where we're going to be putting the grills. Now, they have got some tabs on either side here so that when we put them in, they fit just around the sections here. So one in that side, and again, making sure the tabs are at the side, one in that side just there. So we're now going to be putting this section here on top of this section. You have got some locating holes here for the locating lugs you've got on either side. So make sure that fits perfectly flush in there like that. Then you can secure that in with 5 AP screws. I've got some already loaded in here. So I'll put the center one in first. That's 1. Do the top one. Two. Bottom one. Three. And then just the two on this side over here. God, I'm a bit nifty with a screwdriver today. I'm doing this quite quickly. That never happens. So there we go. So that's what that looks like there. If I turn that over, pretty impressive, huh? I do like the camo pattern on that. That's excellent. Put that to one side. And then once again, you'd be expected to build another three bits of track for the, well, track. That's all there is to do in that stage. Now, stage 37, I need to make sure my workstation's completely clear, because that is this ginormous thing here looking like that. And obviously, this is where the tracks are going to be based to eventually as well. But this is an absolutely ginormous section. Now, we don't actually do anything with that in the stage, but if I go back to this camera, this is giving you an idea of just how big this thing actually is. But put this save to one side, we'll move on to stage 38. Now, stage 38, this is, I believe, our first control board for this build. And as you can see, it looks just like that. It's got the switch on there. I'm guessing that's an on-off switch. But there you go. We're going to take this ginormous section that we just had from the last stage, and I'm going to be mounting this piece here just onto the two lugs over here. So this is just going to go on like that there. It's going to be held into place with AP screws. Two of them. I've got one left over from the last stage, but they do provide more in this one. And then in the little holes that you can just see here, we've got the control board, and obviously the switch is going to go through this hole here, and then the power supply, if you want to power this with a DC adapter, will go through the other side. So we're just going to line this up, make sure the switch goes all the way through, and once again that control board is going to be held in with AP screws, two screws, and then just one on the other side here. You do want to make sure that these line up perfectly, because then that way the switch and the power supply will fit flush on that section, as you can see. The only other thing we've got is a hatch here, which looks like that. That's just going to go over this square section at the bottom here. Now, I don't think it matters what way round it goes, but it is just a pushing thing, just like that. So on top now, we have got what looks like that. I'll say top. This is actually the bottom. But there we go. That's in place. And that is all there is to do in that stage. Now, some tiny details in stage 39. So I'll get all of these out. And the first thing we need is this screw and nut from this bag. And all we're going to do is thread the nut onto the screw. Not all the way. It's going to be around about, I don't know, a little distance from the top there. Stand by. I'll get it to where I think it's got to be. I'm guessing around about there. Perhaps a bit more. That's where it's going to be sitting. Then we're going to take this section here, and we're going to be putting the screw down the top hole, just like this. You will need to screw this with your hands. All the way down. I'm moving that nut just slightly up, because you want the top of this to be in line with these sections here. So get it all the way in. Bang on it there. So that looks like that. Now, if I bring over this large section we were just working on previously, this time we want it this way round. As you can see, we've got some holes just into the side there. We're going to actually want to clamp this just onto the sections here, just behind those holes. Now, they have got locating lugs in this, but basically we're just going to line them up, and if I turn it on the top camera, it's going to go in just like that. Now, we are going to hold this in from the other side, and that's held in with a BM screw. Now, the BM screws are silver flange screws. They're just going to go in here, and that will keep that piece in place. And when that's in, should look like that, and it should be nice and flush in there. Now, we're going to be mounting these three sections here. We've got three of these. Once again, bringing over this large, massive section of the tank here, just behind what we put in at this side, these are just going to be going into these points here. one in here, one next to it, and then finally just one this side over here. Now they're going to be held in from the other side with DP screws. Now you might want to check your bag for this, because it says DP screws, they're actually OP screws. They are flanged, these screws, they look just like that. So get the first one in over here. I don't know if mine's just been misprinted on the bag or if it is actually OP screws that you want to be putting in. As I said, as I chuck my screwdriver around. But yeah, mine were definitely labelled OP. OP. That's the second one. There we go. That's the third one in. So, show you on top. That's looking like that. I'm now going to make up another section here. Lots of small details in this part. So we've got this piece looking like that. And we're going to be taking a PP screw. One of these ones looks like that. That's going to go through the top of this and out the bottom. Get my screwdriver to push that down. So there you go, that looks like that. Then we've got this tiny plastic sort of washer, which is going to go into the end here over that screw. So you might be best to just make sure that you screw this through that. So it's going to come out the other side there. And then we've got this small base here that that's going to go into. So we're going to be screwing this into this base just here like this. Make sure that's screwed in nice and tight. And this should still be able to turn, as you can see that there. There we go, that's that section in. We're going to do that exactly the same way. So we're going to take this section here. We're going to drop down a PP screw, one of the silver ones. Make sure that goes all the way down there. Just like that, fits over one of the washers, the plastic washers, into that section. But this time we're actually putting this into the larger section like that. Excellent. So once again, this still is able to turn on top there. So I've just made two of these up. They now want us to do some tracks, but we have got quite a few parts just left over here, just some detail parts, but they're going to be used in a later stage. Again, lots of fine detail parts in stage 40, just like what we've been doing. Because there are two sides of the tank, it's actually a mirror. It's symmetrical on each side. So if you remember what we did last time, we're just going to be putting the nut into this section here. Getting that around about, just shy of a, or I don't know, it's about 8mm, 7mm from the top. I'd say about a bit more, about that far. And then we're going to put that into this section here, which means screwing that in all the way. You have to do it your hand because there's no way to actually put a screwdriver on there. So just screw that in all the way. And then just like last time where we put this one on this side, we're going to be putting the other one just on the other side in here there. Once again, this is going to be held in with one of the flanged BM screws on both sides. Now we've got one in that side, one in that side. Now, just like we did last time where we put these three on this side, we've actually got some more to put in, but they're just going into the ports at the back here. There's two there to put in. And that one's two, so when they're in, they all look like that. And then once again, we're going to open a PP screw, and we're going to do exactly like we just did previously. Take one of these sections here, drop a PP screw down so it comes out the other side, put a little plastic washer over it there, and then we're going to secure that into this block here. Tighten this up. Once again, that's in place like that, but still able to turn. And do exactly the same thing just on the taller one. There you go, and just tighten this one completely up. Once again, this is able to spin, no problems at all. And then once again, they want us to actually put some more tracks in, another three tracks, and start linking them together. But that's all there is to do in that stage. Even more details in stage 41. So now we've got three of these again in this pack. They're just going to be mirroring what we did on this side. We're going to do that on this side here. So these are going to go in like this, get one in. And then once again, these are held in with DP screws. It does say DP screws. It's not DP screws. On the bag, it says OP screws. So don't get confused by that. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to put all of these in because you've seen this. And I'll show you what that looks like. There you go. That's those three in. Put that to one side. And yes, you have guessed it. Let's just get these open once again. We're going to be taking a PP screw and doing exactly like we did last time by dropping it into the top of one of these just till it comes out the bottom there. Putting a washer over the top and then securing this to one of the bases. You've got a small base and a large base. So that's three of those done. I'm guessing we're going to be doing number four in a second, but we'll have to see how that is. Once again, I keep bringing these over. It wants you to do some more track. At the moment, your track should be looking like this. If you look on the side camera, we've got this one this long. I think we actually linked them all into together, and one which is just slightly shorter by the end of it there. But I don't want you to forget that you have got to do some track sections in this. But that's all there is to do in that stage. So the last stage for this pack is stage 42. And guess what? You know exactly what we're going to be doing. We want to take these two sections here and some OP screws. And just like we've done on this side here, we're going to be putting two. We've done three there. We're going to be putting two at the back. I've started putting these in, but I'll put both of these in and show you what that looks like. So when they're both in, that whole side now looks like that. Once again, we've got a bag of stuff here, and you know exactly what we're going to be doing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to skip through, because we've done this three times already in this stage, and just show you the finished article of what these look like. And there we go. So let's just show you a bit of an inventory of what we've got part wise here. So we've got four of these larger sections here. I'm going to lay these out on my board so you can see what we're left with, because that's all there is to do now in that whole pack. We've got four of these kind here, looking like that. Then we got these things that kind of look like hubs. So one, two, I'm guessing we're going to have four of these, three and four. Then we've got this sort of hub here. We've got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Oh, we got more. Nine, 10, 11 and 12 of those. And then finally, we've got one, two, three and four of those sections here. So this is what we're left over with. I do have quite a few screws, but I do save every screw in that pack. But this is what you should be left with, and obviously everything else is now attached to this section which come in that pack. You know what, because it's the end of the pack, I thought you'd give you an idea of how this is looking so far. I'm guessing that mounts like that. I haven't got a clue. I've just bunged it on hoping that this is what it's going to look like. But this hopefully gives you an idea how big this actually is. You know what? This is one of those times where I think we should do another thumbnail. So you ready? Let's get this set up. Let's go. What do you reckon? That way? There we go. But there you go. That's what it's looking like. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, once again, I'll put the link down here to the Agora Models website. You can get this all the way from pack one. You can build up to where we are at the moment. But I really do hope you like that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.